Hey everyone, this is Sagar Vag, and for next 10 to 15 minutes, I am going to talk about what is composite pattern, why to use it, when to use it, and how to use it. So let's begin. Well, here comes the quick definition. Composite pattern is a structural design pattern that forms a tree structure where each node in the tree is like a container of multiple objects. And consumer can treat each of these node as a single object behaving the same way as that of its inner objects. Yes, this might look confusing at first time, but let's try to understand it with a simple example where we have a folder structure. Each folder may have set of files, set of pictures, set of videos, or even it could have multiple folders inside it. Assume a case where we want to calculate the size of any of the folder in the structure. Let's try to build this requirement without using composite pattern to understand the actual problem. Let's start with an interface iFile that exposes a simple method getSize. Each type of file like documents, pictures, videos, will implement this interface so as to calculate their own size. We will also have a class folder which internally keeps the list of videos, the list of pictures, and even the list of folders to support the nested folder structure. Well, you might say that this folder already looks like a composite. Okay, yes, it is a composite, but it is not following the composite design pattern. Let's see what happens next if we still keep using the folder as it is. Since the structure is ready, the consumer is now willing to calculate the size of any of the folder in the structure. So let's say consumer defines a calculate size method accepting any folder from the structure, and then it internally will start calculating the size for that folder. To begin with, it will start iterating, let's say for example, all the pictures inside the folder to calculate the total size of all the pictures. Similarly, it will continue to calculate the size of all the videos within that folder. And at last, it will iterate over the another folders within that folder, and then it will recursively try to calculate the size of each of those folders, and so on. This still looks okay. It is a working code. It will work for sure. But hey, as a consumer, it's really irritating that you have to remember each and everything. You have to calculate size of each and everything inside that folder. It is as good as you open a Windows Explorer, you open a folder, and then you click on each and every file, videos, folders, and say right click and properties, check the size, add them up, and then calculate the entire size of the root folder. Pathetic, right? You're not going to like it anyways. Before we see how to solve a problem, let's try to summarize the problems which we identified. First one, consumer has an overhead to deal with each and every object within the container to achieve the end result. Second one, if a new object gets added to the container of the hierarchy, then consumer will have to modify its code to support this new tag. So as in our example, if folder starts containing list of music as well, then to calculate the size of the folder, consumer code will now have to be modified to also consider size of each and every song. Okay, enough about the problems. Now let's bring the composite pattern and see how it solves the problem. If you remember the definition which I told you at the start, composite pattern not only composes the different objects into a single container, but it also makes that container to behave the same way as the internal objects, which means the folder in our case will also expose gate size contract, and a consumer will directly ask the size to the folder rather than calculating sizes of each and every internal objects. So for a consumer, a folder is also like a file now. Now since folder acts as a file, we'll have to modify the folder class to implement iFile. And the previous logic of calculating size of folder by iterating over pictures, videos and nested folders, all that logic will be now taken care by the folder. And since it implements iFile interface, it will also implement getSize method. And it will just use the calculateSize method by passing the folder. And as a consumer, your work is much simpler now. Just pick any folder and ask the size. Don't worry about how many videos it has, whether it has documents, pictures, or even nested folders. Just pick the folder and your job is done. So for you, a folder and a file are the same now. Well, if you have already seen my decorator pattern video, you might feel that composite pattern is same as decorator pattern. Well, they are similar but not the same. I am going to take another session to actually compare composite pattern and decorator pattern. So please subscribe to this channel and stay tuned. I hope you understood composite pattern now. Let's take a moment to note down all the advantages of using composite pattern. First one, consumer receives a container having multiple objects, and the container can be treated as one of the objects, making the code simple and readable. Second one, composite pattern follows open-close principle so that whenever new object is added to the hierarchy or within the container, it doesn't impact the consumer code. Also note down the other examples where composite pattern can be useful. First one, you can have a collection of songs or a collection of albums which internally has multiple songs. All of those songs and albums can be composited into a playlist, and playlist can behave the same way as songs and albums, where you can directly play or share that playlist. Second example is where multiple insurances can be composited into a policy, where you can directly buy a policy or even terminate it. Hope this video was simple enough to understand. But if you are still confused that how to decide if I should use composite pattern, then you should ask this question to yourself. Do you have a use case where you have a hierarchy or a tree-like structure where each node in that tree should support same set of operations as that of the internal objects? If the answer to this question is yes, you should use composite pattern. Well, that's it. I hope you liked this video and now you understand the composite pattern. Well, if you want to be stronger, your efforts should be stronger enough. So keep reading more and more about composite pattern. Try to get more hands-on experience on it. Try to get in-depth knowledge about composite pattern. This is Sagar Wagh, and I am here to explain design concepts in as simple way as possible. Hope Optimus Growth Channel helps you to grow and let you grow the others. Please subscribe for all upcoming videos and do share all of them with your friends. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you so much.